There have been a lot of breakthroughs when it comes to treating HIV over the last few years. The virus was identified in the 1980s, and it was deadly. Now, with years of research, funding, and testing, the virus is a manageable, chronic condition that has seen some encouraging breakthrough research that can hopefully end the HIV virus for good. How is the virus spreading today? Where can you get tested? And how close are we to a vaccine or a cure for patients who live with it today? Joining me this morning is Dr. Laura Cheever, a physician and the Associate Administrator for the U.S. Health Resources and Services Administration, to talk about these things. Good morning, Doctor. Welcome to Maryland Perspectives.
Good morning, and thanks for your interest.
How many people are living with HIV today?
In the United States, there are 1.2 million people living with HIV.
What is the most common way that the virus is transmitted?
In the United States, an overwhelming majority of virus is transmitted sexually today, both among men who have sex with men and transmitted heterosexually. About 7% of new infections in the most recent data collected were from people who injected drugs. So it really is primarily a sexually transmitted infection.
So what's the quality of life like with treatments that are available if somebody is diagnosed with HIV?
I think that's really the exciting part of HIV. I started providing HIV care in 1990, where, as you mentioned, getting HIV was really a death sentence for people. In the mid-90s, we developed new treatments, and those treatments have only gotten better and better. Today, for someone diagnosed, they can usually be started on one pill once a day with little or no side effects and live a near normal lifespan. The important part there is people need to get tested. People that are tested soon after they've acquired their HIV infection and get on treatment really should not develop significant side effects or complications of HIV.
In my research for this interview, I found out about the stages of HIV, with stage three being AIDS, which is the one that a lot of people talk about. So does the treatment you receive depend on the stage that you're in? So you're talking about getting tested. You should probably get it done really early.
Yes. Luckily, the stage of disease is not important for treatment. People that are quite ill in the hospital with late stage complications because they did not get tested in a timely way usually do just as well on medication as people who are treated early in their infection. So one pill once a day, it really is a life changer for someone with HIV infection.
So who should be getting tested today, and how frequently should they get tested?
The CDC recommends that every adult in the United States get at least one HIV test in their lifetime. For anyone who's had sex with more than one person, who's had sex with more than one other person, should get tested for HIV. So that is many people in the United States. Depending on your risk, you should get tested more frequently. So if you're a person who's having sex with multiple other partners, or your partner is having sex with multiple other people, you should be tested probably annually.
Now, if you test positive for HIV, where can you go for information about finding affordable treatment?
We are really fortunate in the United States. We have something called the Ryan White HIV AIDS Program, which is a government program that was first brought into law in 1990. So it's 30 years of the program this year.
Wow.
And that program provides free or low-cost HIV care and treatment for people that are uninsured, or if they're insured but with their copays and deductibles they can't afford it and they're low income, they can get help through that program. It's very easy to find out where you can get help. It should be available in your community. You can go to the website hab.hrsa.gov, and you'll find a spot there where you can put in your zip code and be linked to places in your community where you can get HIV care.
So you talk about how exciting a lot of this new research is and about how easy it is to live with HIV and AIDS today. I've read of two patients that have been cured of AIDS. One was in 2008 and now one back in March. How close do you think we are to an actual cure for everybody, or at least a vaccine like we have with HPV?
I wish I could say we were close to that. I do not think we are. Those two cases that you speak of are both people that had forms of cancer where they had to essentially have their own innate immune system wiped out.
Wow.
And they were given a bone marrow transplant, so that's a very dangerous procedure. That for people with certain kinds of leukemia or lymphoma, it's necessary for survival, but not what we're going to do for people that don't absolutely require it. So I am not hopeful that we are going to cure people of HIV anytime soon under normal circumstances. And getting a vaccine for HIV has been very, very difficult because of the way the vaccine interacts with the human immune system. So I don't think that is going to be a good option for us in the next 10 years. That said, we can end the HIV epidemic in the United States. We have the tools we need now, and it's really it's a two-pronged approach. The first is, as we've discussed, if you have HIV and you get on therapy and you take it every day, this means the person needs to get tested and then get connected to care and stay in care and get on therapy, which is usually one pill once a day. That therapy is effective, someone becomes undetectable, we say. Their viral load becomes undetectable. The medicine works very, very well. The virus is not circulating in their blood in a way that it can infect other people. So that person will live a near normal lifespan and will not be able to transmit HIV sexually to someone else. So that's huge. On the other side of the equation, we have people who are at high risk for HIV who test negative, but they're at high risk, and they can be on a pill, one pill once a day, to help prevent them from getting HIV. We call that PrEP, and PrEP is also available now. So that whether you have HIV or whether you're at high risk for HIV but you don't have it, we can prevent HIV infection. And if we put those two things together at a community level, we can end the epidemic in this country. And I got to say, Baltimore is working hard at that. The health department is in it to win it, and it's working well.
That's awesome. That makes me, because I, you know, was in high school back in the 80s, and I remember as a young woman who was just becoming sexually active, how scary this was. I'm looking at it through a lens of today with the pandemic, and, you know, just because it's sexually transmitted, it's still a really, really scary kind of time back then. And to hear about the breakthroughs, that's amazing. That's really great. So once again, what's that website to learn more about your administration and the Ryan White HIV AIDS program?
So if you want to figure out where you can get HIV care and treatment, you can go to hab.hrsa.gov. If you want to get an HIV test, you can go to hiv.gov and put in your zip code and find out where to get a test. And during this pandemic, we've really very quickly pivoted to doing self-testing so people can get tested in their home. Certainly, if you go to your doctor's office, you can get tested there. But the health departments have numerous places where you can get HIV self-testing. Someone can mail you a test kit, and you can get tested in your home and either read the results yourself under one type of testing or send a blood spot back to a lab for a different kind of home testing. And it makes all the difference in the world that you actually can get tested in your own home.
You're not kidding. That's amazing. That's really, really
amazing. It is amazing.
More people will do it. It's almost like everything's like at-home testing these days, too, because you can do colon screenings that way. And, you know, we should probably do all the sexually transmitted diseases that way, where you can just kind of, there's so much shame involved with this. You know, a lot of people don't want to come forward. Yeah, you're doing a great job. Dr. Laura Cheever is an Associate Administrator for the Health Resources and Services Administration, HIV AIDS Bureau. I'll make sure I get that link up on our website, 98online.com/Maryland Perspectives. Thank you, Doctor, for all the information today and helping stop the spread of HIV AIDS.
Thank you so much.